Hey, this is Ron from HVAC Training Solutions. If you stick with me here for the next couple minutes, at the end of this short video, I'll give you a sample of some of the HVAC training that we can provide to you online. So if you're watching this video, you have probably been searching high and low for the right HVAC course that fits your budget, that fits your needs, schedule, and so forth. You've probably looked at HVAC colleges, trade schools, and other online courses. It gets pretty confusing trying to figure that out. So first of all, I'm going to help you figure out if HVAC might be right for you, and then hopefully you'll figure out that our training is a good fit for you as well. So the HVAC industry. The jobs in the HVAC industry are growing 21% faster than the national average. In fact, I think that's going to get even greater as years go by. The reason being is the older HVAC technicians are retiring and leaving the trades at a rate of 4 or 5 to 1. So that means that there's 4 or 5 older HVAC technicians that are hanging up their tool belts to every one technician that's coming in new. So the job market is just going to get bigger and bigger as time goes on. Now the average salary for the HVAC technicians is about $45,000 a year. But you can earn $60,000 to $65,000 a year after about 5 years. You need to make sure that you're a top-notch technician, on top of your game, well-educated, and great with people. There's always jobs available. It does not matter whether you live on the East Coast or the West Coast, up in the northern snow country or down where it's smoking hot in Texas. There's always jobs, no matter where you go. The other thing is, you got to be pretty smart. This is a thinking man's trade. You need to understand welding and brazing, electricity, plumbing. You need to be able to troubleshoot electronically. You also have to be a salesman, and you have to help people through those times when they've been without heat or air conditioning and just are miserable. So is online training in the HVAC industry right for you? Only you can decide that. But what I can tell you, if you're motivated, you're looking for great training that fits your schedule, this is the course for you. And if you're not willing to be motivated and participate and communicate and work hard to learn a trade that can pay very well, then this course isn't for you. So hopefully you'll decide that it is. If you have any questions after watching these videos, you can give me a call, 904-742-9511, and I will help you in any way that I can. Now stand by for your short HVAC training video. In this demonstration, we're going to use a multimeter and a schematic, and then we're going to look at what a normal compressor should look like if you're going to ohm out the windings because you're suspecting that it's bad. The thing that you need to be aware of, though, is when you are doing resistance measurements on any component, you need to disconnect these wires here, or unplug the plugs, or disconnect the wires so you isolate the component that you're testing. If you don't, then you're going to it'll backfeed through other components within the system. So make sure that you disconnect the component that you're checking when you're doing a resistance measurement. So you grab your meter and you're going to switch it to ohms. And we're going to measure between the common and the run winding. And that gives us a resistance measurement of 2 ohms. Then you're going to measure between the common and the start winding. That gives you a resistance measurement of 10 ohms. Now, you can see here in the schematic diagram that if you measure from start to run, it should be the total of the two measurements that you just took, which were 10 and 2 ohms. And you see here, this is a good compressor. We measured 10 ohms across common to start, 2 ohms across common to run, and then a total of 12 ohms across start to run. Now, the different compressors will have different resistance measurements, but the total between common and start and common and run, if you total those up, that's what you should be measuring between start and run windings. And if you're measuring anything over 20 ohms on any leg, you probably have a bad compressor, but this is this one happened to check out good. So the next one we'll look at is an open winding in the compressor.